Hi everybody, what we have here today and in this video I will show you is a more than 25 years old hot water power washer. It's a really hard worker, perfect reliable machine, but there were some problems with this machine, so we had to fix it. In this particular video I'll explain you what was causing the problem with overheating motor and the thermal fuse protected motor and switch was switching off engine. So first I'll describe you for few things. As you can see over here you have pistons. The proper level of the oil is in the middle of the visor. You should use oil 15W40, but it is according to advice from authorized service 10W30 or 10W40 will do as well and will do the job. Remember, if you would like to change the oil seals, which are behind these silicone, yellow silicone seals that are protecting against the dirt, you have to change them from the front side. As you can see, the pump was disconnected, is over here. It's a really massive pump with the brass screws. And if you would like to change the oil, for example, you can unscrew this one, this plastic screw, and unscrew this. And then you can put the dirty oil into something like that, or some bucket or something. Always use for releasing plastic screws tools like this one. And what else should I tell you before I start about the induction motor? I can tell you that, as you can see, I have already disconnected the diesel tank and the metal spiral, the coil where the water is being heated. Over here is the thermal fuse that is protecting the induction motor against overheating. You can, if you would like to take it out, you can just use ordinary screw and get it out. This is the switch which you should push if you would like to start the induction motor again. After it was cooling, it's already cooled after cooling down. We will go to the front part, and the most difficult part is to, I'll tell you what can possibly cause overheating of the engine, such a reliable, professional, commercial induction motor, which is, by the way, made by Portotecnica. It's Italian brand, very well known. And but as I have mentioned, the engine itself or motor itself is not 25 but 30 years old. It was built or produced in 1993. It's 1.2 kilowatt. And so I was guessing what could possibly be causing overheating of this small induction motor. So first of all, I thought that the problem could be with bearings. Bearings, one is over there behind this front cover and another is somewhere there, but this one couldn't be causing problems because it's actually in the oil bath. So it is all right. The second thing that could possibly be causing overheating of the motor was that because the power washer wasn't used for a long time, maybe for over 10 years, the water condensate inside the engine or inside the motor, and the rust, there could be possibly rust on the stator or on the rotor as well. And the third option, the worst, could be that the wiring of the induction motor went wrong, and this is causing overheating. Fortunately, in this case, the problem was not the bearings, even they needed the grease, silicone grease or oil as well, but the problem was that the rust was in the beside the or in the middle between the stator and rotor, and there was a friction, and this friction was causing overheating of the engine. Actually, to the worst part, and the worst part in repairing of this machine was to take down this fan, this plastic electric fan, which is cooling down the induction motor. I don't know who engineered this, but it was like a challenge. I guess that in the professional services they don't bother, they just destroy it and get a new spare part. So, because first, if you like to get to this bearing and oil it and then clean the stator and rotor, you have to take down this and this front part of the induction motor. As I have already mentioned, the biggest challenge was to take out or take down or take off this plastic fan, which is cooling down the induction motor. And there is usually it's somewhere here, just half of the centimeters away from the front cover. You have to use a lot of WD-40 from this side and from this side as well, and leave it overnight so it can be released easier. But even after using WD-40, sometimes it's very difficult to take it out. So now it's already released, as you can see. I had to use such a metal. I put one behind and one over here and pull it out. Even used a hair dryer like this to heat this part, this front part. So, because I didn't want to break the tooth or what you like, I'll show you them how they look, which are usually, or they are in the hole, which is on the shaft. So I'll show you. I'll take it out. And first of all, you have to, before you even start trying to get it out, you have to, with the screwdriver, pull out this metal part. And then you can start trying to get it out. As I have mentioned, you can see them here. They are like human tooths. They are plastic, and in the end they've got something which actually fits in this hole in the shaft, and it is protecting, so it won't go off during 2750 RPMs when it's cooling down the induction motor. But the problem is that it's a difficult to get it out when you need to get into the engine. So what I was doing, actually, when it was there, underneath every of these single, I call them tooths, I pull it with a screwdriver, thin screwdriver, and under every single one I put such a copper, I don't know if you see it properly, copper metal part, just to overcome the hole in the shaft and this tooth. And then I used mentioned metal parts and took it out. It was really a challenge because you can damage easily this, and if you damage it, you need to get a spare part because you won't fix it. So they could actually engineer it in easier, I don't know how, but because this is really challenging to replace it, or you know. So if it's done, as you can see, I have already got rid of the or I unscrewed the screws, four of them. Never use keys like this one. The reason why, if you damage the head of the screw, you are done. You are practically, you can nothing do with this motor anymore, and that's it. Always use one of these, that's the best option. Or another handy tool is this one. After so many years of service, usually they are not released during this service, they are fixed there really tight. So you have to be very careful when you're releasing them. Do it gently, slowly, before you can use WD-40, just try to oil it a little bit. And whenever it's done, and you successfully took them out, you can pull the shaft with the front cover and you will see the rotor. Now you see that it goes easily because everything is already cleaned. You see that this is a massive rotor, it's a professional rotor, very, very reliable. And over here, there is a bearing, as I've mentioned. I'll turn it a little bit so you can see. It's already oiled, but it wasn't moving like this before. So you see, it goes perfectly, no vibration, nothing like that. And what was the causing problem was that this part, there was a rust over here, and inside on the stator part as well. And this was causing friction and overheating. So now it should be, I hope it should be all right. So you can oil this bearing. You don't have to oil the bearing over there. You can see there are practically three parts. Over here is a stator and rotor. Over here is a part where there is this shaft connected to the part where the oil and the pistons and other things are. So I'll put it back. I don't know because I don't know if you see something. I can't zoom in. I'll try to do my best. Which actually is pretty clever design and very, very reliable induction motor. It worked for a long time, I guess, but it's in really good shape after three decades. And when you did clean it, you can use something against the rust and something like that. You know, because you don't need, you must not scratch the surface. You have to get rid of the rust, but you must not scratch the surface. So use something to clean it, then dry it out. The same with the stator. And whenever it's done, you can just pull it back there. And that's it. Put the screws back. Then oil this plastic fan properly, not oil, I use this liquid moly silicon grease, is perfect. You can use it for O-rings, for seals and for things like that, for shaft, and it does the job. So I hope this video helped you, and do your best. I wish you will be able to fix your motor, whoever you are, whether you are individual owner of such a perfect machine, or you are a businessman or employer, and employees work with this tool, with this power washer for you, or you are even a serviceman, because I had a big problem to find somebody, not even in professional services, who would be able to fix this motor, whether pump or this overheating or blocked pipes or many other issues that were, because this power washer was used, I guess, the way use it and abuse it, and is not the proper way of using such a great machine or great machines. So I hope this video helped you. Have a nice day and do your best.